vehicle has landed.
Many thought space exploration would continue to evolve.
What these men have done has been a great inspiration to all of us.
Fast forward.
The Observer is the latest in a string of blunders that have cost taxpayers billions of dollars.
Some people are gloomy about the future of space exploration.
Further budget cuts could destroy the agency.
America's space program must be relevant to our broad national needs if it's going to continue to be supported by members of Congress and by the American people.
The real problem we have is communicating the importance of space for the benefit of humanity.
When we have the adjective space in front of something, quite a few people's eyes glaze over. My name is Frank White. I consider myself a philosopher of space exploration. I was watching This Week with David Brinkley, and Tom Wolfe said,
"The country has never had a philosophy of space exploration. It didn't need it at the beginning. All that was required was to catch up with the Soviets in space. Once we had done that, we had won the space race, suddenly NASA found itself without a philosophy of space."
And I've been trying to create a philosophy ever since. And the astronauts discover that we're citizens of the universe. The overview effect is a shift in their perception of the Earth and a shift in identity.
Space provides us an emotional challenge. It stimulates our desires for knowledge.
In 2008, I launched on Space Shuttle Atlantis, STS-122. And then in November of 2009, I flew STS-129. 3, 2, 1. You know you're going somewhere. You just hope you're going to the right place, and you're just hauling. And you're shaking so much, and your eyes are trying to focus on the screens. You just see squiggly lines. And then at about 2.5 minutes, the solid rocket boosters jettison. You're seeing the plume going back down to the planet, and then 6.5 minutes later, you're in space. And then you look over at the window and you see the colors of the ocean that you need new definitions of blue to describe what you see because it's just so beautiful. And I'm looking out the window at my hometown, and 5 minutes later, we're over Leo Ihart's hometown in Paris. I had this cognitive shift in the way that I think about humanity from seeing the planet from that vantage point.
They don't see borders and boundaries from space. Your home becomes the world.
There are no words I can accurately put to describe the feeling of being able to look out a bay window and seeing all of the world and all of everything that you've ever known and every person that you've been close to and every experience you've ever had in one glimpse of the eye.
And so many of the astronauts want to communicate this. I'm lucky. That's why they talk to me.
It's overwhelming. It's awe-inspiring. It's a view I wish every person on Earth could have so we could understand our home better.
Apollo 8 is probably the most profound mission in that regard, because on the way to the moon, they turned the cameras around.
Oh my God, look at that picture over there. There's the Earth coming up. Wow, is that crazy. Hey, don't take that, I'm scheduled.
That was the first time we on Earth really saw the entire Earth, the whole Earth, against the backdrop of the universe. The environmental movement got a huge boost from the Apollo missions in particular. If we're citizens of the universe, how do we benefit the universe?
My name is Holly Ridings. I'm the NASA Chief Flight Director, and we are responsible for the operations of all of NASA's human spaceflight missions.
Ridings is the first woman to be appointed to this position.
There's always like this period right before launch or right before docking. It gets really quiet, and everybody just sort of naturally understands the seriousness of it.
Liftoff of the 25th Space Shuttle mission.
When I was young and in school, the Challenger accident happened.
A huge fireball in the sky.
We have a report from the flight dynamics officer that the vehicle has exploded. Flight director confirms that. We are looking at...
I watched it happen, and it's even now still hard for me to talk about, but many people's reaction was, hey, I don't want anything to do with that. My reaction was, I'm going to go figure that out. I'm going to go help. I'm going to go make a difference. So that's why I'm here.
You know, with any type of exploration, there's a risk involved. We've lost two space shuttles. We lost an Apollo craft on the pad. You know, I lost friends. But is it worth the money? Is it worth the risk? And I would say it is.
We fail in communicating the huge impact of space activities in day-by-day life. Everything will stop if we switch off satellites. I'm Simonetta Di Pippo. I'm currently the director of the Office for Outer Space Affairs at the United Nations. The main goal of the Office for Outer Space Affairs is to bring the benefits of space activities to humankind, from smart and precise agriculture to telemedicine, food and water security to wildlife and biodiversity. When you have a challenging objective, you always need to develop disruptive technologies.
We have one experiment where we're looking at Parkinson's disease. And we have millions of people on the ground who are affected by this disease, but the protein crystals don't grow large enough on Earth for us to accurately investigate the causes of the disease. And so we are growing the crystals in a microgravity environment. Me personally, I touch multiple experiments every single day. For the future, we are investigating ourselves. We look back at the Earth and help farmers understand how to better irrigate their fields. It's everything from the human body to the physics.
What we are trying to do is use space activities to bring countries together, to demonstrate that through space, you can maintain peace, not only in space, but also on Earth.
We're solving really hard problems in a cooperative, positive way.
We got so much more than just Tang out of this exercise. We have satellites, remote sensing systems. We advance ourselves as we explore.
So the question really, I think that's important to say is, who are we if we stop exploring?
Our ventures into space lead us towards a better understanding of our planet, of our solar system, and perhaps of ourselves.